Glory be to the Lord's holy name. We'll move on to the reading from the scriptures. And I'll bring God's word.
Bible reading is taken from Book of Psalms 118 verses 1 to 9. O give thanks unto the Lord, for he is good, because his mercy endureth forever. Let Israel now say that his mercy endureth forever. Let the house of Aaron say, now say that his mercy endureth forever. Let them now that fear the Lord say that his mercy endureth forever. I called upon the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a large place. The Lord is on my side, I will not fear. What can man do unto me? The Lord taketh my part with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desire upon them that hate me. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. The reading will continue.
The reading continues from verses 10 to 17. All nations compassed me about, but in the name of the Lord will I destroy them. They compassed me about, yea, they compassed me about, but in the name of the Lord I will destroy them. They compass me about like bees. They are quenched as the fire of thorns. For in the name of the Lord I will destroy them. Thou hast thrust so at me that I might fall, but the Lord helped me. The Lord is my strength and song, and is become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacles of the righteous. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doeth valiantly. I shall not die, but live, and declare the works of the Lord. Here ends the Bible reading. Thanks be to God.
The caption for this morning meditation: the hand of the Lord is with me. The hand of the Lord is with you. The hand of the Lord is with us. Hand of the Lord. Acts 11:21. And the hand of the Lord was with them. When we read the Bible carefully, the hand of the Lord is upon somebody, upon a nation, upon a group of people, upon a kingdom, upon a king, either for good or for bad. Either for good or for bad. When the hand of the Lord is with us, when the hand of the Lord with the servants of God, with the apostles, with the children of God, is always for their good. When the hand of the Lord with God's enemies, it is for their destruction. In this morning, we are meditating the hand of the Lord is with us. For our own blessing, the hand that sustained us, the hand that has carried us through, the hand that is leading us, the hand that has lifted us above, the hand that has wiped away our tears, the hand that has touched us and healed us, that hand is with us. The mighty hand of God, the valiant hand of God, the hand of the Lord is with us. Chapter 4 verses 23 and 24. I'd love to show you a few passages to encourage you before we could get into the Lord's table. Joshua chapter 4 verses 23 and 24. For the Lord your God dried up the waters of Jordan from before you until you were passed over, as the Lord your God did to the Red Sea, which he dried up from before us until we were gone over. Verse 24. that all the people of the earth might know the hand of the Lord that is mighty, that is might, fear the Lord your God. The hand of the Lord is with us. The whole world could see the hand of the Lord is with us. How could the whole world could see the hand of the Lord is with us, and the hand of the Lord is mighty, the hand of the Lord is valiant. How could the whole world could see the hand of the Lord is with me? My dear brother, my dear sister, number one, when the world could see, the Lord makes way for you. When the Lord opens way for you, when the Lord removes hurdles before you, when the world could see, when there is no way, the Lord is making a way for you. When the world could see that the Lord is making a way for you, the whole world will say, yes, the hand of the Lord is with him. Truly, it is the hand of the Lord with that sister. It is the hand of the Lord with that servant of God. Truly, it is because of the hand of the Lord they are able to do this great thing. The way is shut against you. The mighty Red Sea, Egyptian army at the back. They say, now the way is closed for them. They cannot go further. The way is closed for them. On either side, huge mountains. Now they are caught between the devil and the deep sea. The Egyptian army and the Red Sea. The Lord opened up a way for them. Now the Egyptians could see, and all those could hear about that could see, the hand of the Lord was with these Israelites, with these poor slaves who are recently delivered. The Lord is opening up a way for them. They are in the wilderness. The whole world, the Moabites, Ammonites, Amalekites, Philistines, everybody thought the wilderness has shut them. They are closed in within that wilderness. They are doomed in the wilderness. They cannot go forward. They cannot inherit the promised land. When the whole world could think that they cannot inherit the promised land, the Lord opened up a way for them in the River Jordan. Then the world could see the hand of the Lord is with them. The hand of the Lord is with them. Whenever the Lord could open up a way for you, when the world thinks it is shut, he opens that nobody could shut. In your ministry, in your business, in your family life, for the marriage of your children, marriage, when you think that everything is closed, when the Lord opens up a miraculous way in your life, then the whole world could see the Lord, the Lord's hand is with them. Number two, Ezra chapter 7. Ezra chapter 7 verse 6. This Ezra went up from Babylon, and he was a ready scribe in the law of Moses, which the Lord God of Israel had given. And the king granted him all his request according to the hand of the Lord his God upon him. Number two, to get your endeavors prosper. There was an assignment for Eleazar. It prospered because the hand of the Lord was with Eleazar. There is an assignment before the scribe Ezra, a ready scribe, a seasoned scribe. He was well versed in the teachings or in the law of Moses. But he has got a few requirements. He has to go to Jerusalem from Babylon. He needed money, he needed people with him. He was a slave, though he was a ready scribe, a seasoned scribe. Therina Veda Parag. So he needed some assistance. The king, the pagan king, granted unto him everything he wanted. The pagan king granted unto him everything he wanted. It's because the hand of the Lord was with Ezra. When I was in the secular job, I have seen that. Everything I wanted, I could easily get it. It's all because the hand of the Lord is with Ezra. And we read in the same chapter, verse 28, and hath extended mercy unto me before the king. Now Ezra confesses, he hath extended mercy unto me before the king. God hath extended mercy unto me before the king and his counselors, before the counselors of the king, and before all the king's mighty princes. And I was strengthened as the hand of the Lord my God was upon me. And I gathered together out of Israel chief men to go up with me. Number two, I love to tell you. You have to pray that the hand of the Lord should be with you. It speaks about not just the presence of God, the mighty power of God, wisdom, grace, anointing, mercy, the very presence of God. God's hand is with you. God is doing everything in you, through you, for you. So when God's mercy upon you, in other words, when God's hand is upon you, your endeavors will prosper. God was with Solomon. Solomon was able to build that mighty temple. Solomon was able to build that mighty temple. It's all because God's hand was with Solomon. Because God's hand was with Solomon, Solomon was able to build that mighty temple. My dear brother, my dear sister, let me go quickly to number three. Number three, Isaiah chapter 41, from verse 17 to 20. Isaiah 41, from verse 17 to 20. When the poor and needy seek water, and there is none, and their tongue faileth for thirst, I the Lord will hear them, I the God of Israel will not forsake them. I'll open the rivers in high places and fountains in the midst of valleys, and I'll make the wilderness a pool of water and the dry land springs of water. I will plant in the wilderness the cedar, the shittah tree and the myrtle and the oil tree. I will set in the desert the fir tree and the pine and the box tree together, that they may see and know and consider and understand together that the hand of the Lord hath done this, and the Holy One of Israel hath created it. Number three, to prove that you will not be forsaken. The hand of the Lord is with you. It is to make a way for you. It is to grant unto you or to make you an endeavor prosper. Number three, to prove, to show that you will not be forsaken. He will not leave alone. You are standing before the Red Sea, you will not be forsaken. You are standing before before River Jordan, you will not be forsaken. You are standing before the fort of Jericho, you will not be forsaken. You have to face 7 races and 31 kings, you will not be forsaken. The Lord will not leave you alone. He will not forsake you. To prove that He will not forsake you, you will not be forsaken. The hand of the Lord is with you. In verse 17, the poor and needy seek water. It is not literally financially poor. Poor and weak. It speaks about our humble situation. We are unable to do anything on our own. The poor and needy seek water, not apple juice or anything, just seek water, and there is none. It appears that their basic need is also not met with, and their tongue faileth for thirst. Their tongue is parched. Their tongue faileth for water. I, the Lord, will hear them. They are praying. They are poor and needy. They are seeking for water, and their tongue faileth for water. They could not find water. They are crying unto the Lord. The Lord will hear them. I, the Lord of Israel, will not forsake them. How do I know that the Lord will not forsake me? I believe the Lord will not forsake me. How will I know the Lord will not forsake me? I will open rivers in high places. He'll make way in the Red Sea. He'll make way in the River Jordan. Here we see He will make rivers in high places where we cannot have rivers. Rivers can be in the valleys. All of a sudden, high places, there will be rivers. How is it possible there could be rivers in high places and fountains in the midst of the valleys? There will be fountains, rivers, fountains in the midst of the valleys. I will make wilderness a pool of water and dry land springs of water. There are four things: rivers of water flowing from a high place to a low place, the rivers of water, then fountains of water. They just splash through. Fountains of water. Number three, pool of waters, something like a pond, something like a lake. There will be pool of water and then springs of water. When the Lord wants to bless you, He blesses you different ways. Maybe to make you understand. You are going through a financial constraint. I have seen many a time zero. Though I have seen zero, I am always hero. The Lord has never forsaken me. And in many different ways, the Lord will be meeting your needs. It will be very wonderful. Just imagine. Just a financial constraint. You are crying unto the Lord. You don't know what to do. You have to pay the fees for your children. You have to pay the school fees. You don't know what to do. And you are praying and praying and praying. Or maybe is for the wedding of your daughter. You need financial assistance. You are believing in the Lord. You are praying. Just you want to have a basic needs. And there is no way that you could get it. Your tongue faileth for thirst. Your tongue is parched. You don't know what you are going to do. You have to pay the fees. You have to buy that. You have to get money for your daughter's wedding. Some difficult situation. The Lord will not forsake you. How do you know the Lord will not forsake you? All of a sudden, somebody years back borrowed 10,000 from you. And He is bringing that money to you. When you are just wondering how, I never expected that man would bring that money. After a few minutes or after within half an hour, another man is coming to you, give a contract. You expected him to pay 10% that he could start the contract. Now you are wondering, If that fellow gives only 10%, I cannot do anything. Maximum you can demand 30%. Maximum you can demand 30%. Today you are thinking because of a difficult situation, it's a 10 lakh project. Because of a difficult situation, you are thinking at least I'll ask that fellow to give 50%, and you can tell him that I can start the business only if he could give 50%. You are thinking about it. That man says, sir, how much? 10 lakhs. Sir, take all the 100%, you finish it in time, sir. I'll pay the full amount, sir, you finish it in time. You could not believe it. Will that happen? Yes, it happened. One day we made a commitment to buy 2 chairs for the church Sunday morning. Sister prayed, I prayed. I didn't know sister prayed, sister didn't know I prayed. We wanted, each one of us wanted to buy a chair for our church. It was very difficult in those days. Even in those days it was 250 rupees. What I mean is it may be 82, 83. 82, 83, 250 rupees is a very big amount for us. It's a very big amount for us. We just came back home. One man came to give their son for tuition to sister. The sister said, yes, send him. That man took 1,000 rupees. Or 1,200 rupees, I think. He took 1,200 rupees. In that day, it was a very big amount again. And he said, sister, Amma, you take it for the whole year. You take it for the whole year. It's a big surprise. The same afternoon, we both went to the Wasans in Amanjikere. We bought those 2 chairs. And we were the first one. We are very happy. We are very happy, excited that we were giving those 2 chairs. And we were not sitting, both were not sitting in the chairs. First row on the ground I'll be sitting, almost first or second row on the ground sister will be sitting. But we were very happy to give those chairs to the church. So all of a sudden the money that you never expected will come back to you. Maybe another amount will come as a contract. Suddenly you'll get a note from the bank. Your FD matured. So there will be rivers of water. There will be fountains of water. There will be pool of water. There will be springs of water. You thought there was no water. When the Lord performs a miracle, from all sources your blessing will come. From all sources your blessing will come. You may not know how it comes. My dear brother, my dear sister, there was much to say in my savings. I was able to have my daughter's wedding. We were able to have a son's wedding here. Without any financial difficulty. It's all because the Lord wanted to show that He will not forsake us. The hand of the Lord is upon us. If you read the Bible carefully, the hand of the Lord is upon us either for good or for bad. It all depends who we are. If we are on the Lord's side, the hand of the Lord is for good. If we are against God and God's principles, in obeying God's statutes, in honoring God, the hand of the Lord again will be upon us for our own doom. My dear brother, my dear sister, the hand of the Lord is upon them to show that they will not be forsaken. Isaiah chapter 62. I read this passage, what I read earlier, Isaiah 41. Verse 19, I will plant in the wilderness the cedar, the shittah tree, and the myrtle tree, and the oil tree. He will plant all these trees in the wilderness, and set in the desert the fir tree, and the pine tree, and the box tree together, He'll do all these things for you, that they may see, others would see and know. They see and know, number three, and consider, number four, and understand together. They will see, they will know, they will consider, and they will understand together that the hand of the Lord hath done this. The hand of the Lord has done this. My dear brother, my dear sister, Isaiah 62, from verse 1, for Zion's sake will I not hold my peace, and for Jerusalem's sake I will not rest until the righteousness thereof go forth as brightness, and the salvation thereof as a lamp that burneth. And the Gentiles see thy righteousness, and all the kings thy glory. And thou shalt be called by a new name, which the mouth of the Lord shall name. Thou shalt also be crown of glory in the hand of the Lord, and a royal diadem in the hand of thy God. Thou shalt no more be termed forsaken, neither shall thy land any more be termed desolate. But thou shalt be called Hephzibah, and thy land Beulah, for the Lord delighteth in thee, and thy land shall be married. Is all matter the Lord is delighted in. The Lord is delighted in you. There are different situations in the past in my life. They thought he is doomed. God has forsaken. He would become a desolate. He would become a desolate. But the Lord has never forsaken. All people could see it. Kings could see it. Kingsmen could see it. The Lord has been with me. I am excited to see all these things in my life. The Lord will not leave you. The Lord will not forsake you. My dear brother, my dear sister, just I want to share these points with you. Number one, if the Lord is delighted in you, if you are on the Lord's side, the hand of the Lord is upon you. The hand of the Lord is upon you to make a way for you, to grant your endeavors a success, and also to prove to your friends, your classmates, your colleagues, your neighbors, your unsaved relatives, the Lord is with you. My dear brother, my dear sister, a servant of God, the youngest in the family, one day, a family member said, "You are the chief in our family. You are the chief in our family." Chinnavan ayirum, siriyavan balatha jadiyumava. The hand of the Lord will do it. They will see that you are not forsaken. Number four, to know his mercy endures forever. The hand of the Lord is upon you. When I was reading Bible yesterday, on my regular Bible reading, Acts chapter 11 came to me. The hand of the Lord was with them. I prayed for my sake. Lord, let your hand be with me. Let your hand be with me. My dear brother, my dear sister, Lord, even your hand has been with me in the past. You are good unto me in all these years. Even before I got saved, your mercy upon me. Because of your mercy, I got saved. From the time that I am born again, in a wonderful way you are leading me. In my studies, your hand was with me. In my job situation, your hand was with me. In my marriage, your hand was with me. In all different workplaces, you placed me, your hand was with me. Even when I was 21 years old, the Lord, you have started using me in the ministry. Your hand has been with me, O Lord. Your hand has been with me, O Lord. When I was to come for full-time ministry, your hand has been with me. When we think about our children, your hand has been with us. The studies of our children, your hand has been with us. When I resigned my secular job and came for the ministry, not one day I lacked any good thing. We were going through straight paths, difficult paths. My dear brother, my dear sister, when we started this ministry, I had only 2 pants, 2 kurtas. I used to sit on the floor. But then Stephen was helping us in the ministry in those days. He was staying with us. By profession, he was a tailor. I would sit and squat and cross my legs. I will hear something, tru, 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 tru. I know my pants is getting torn. I'll pull my sleeve, I'll pull my kurta and cover it. Monday, he will stitch it, hand stitch it. Carefully we wash, press it. I have to use that throughout that week, those 2 pants. From Chennai, in a moped, I'll go all the way to Vandalur. Today I got hepta with this. It was the fruit of the labor that I had in those days. It was a dusty, rusty path. I go with white pants, white kurta. I'll come back from Vandalur with brown pants and brown kurta. Sister was to wash it, hand wash it. I was wearing white. You know the difficult paths we went through? Because I was wearing white. During the service, one brother was calculating how much soap a sister should use. Then Neelam, Tinapal, starch. Because pastor is using white, how much extra pastor has to spend? When we heard, we wept. How much believers calculate? We were in a good job, we are earning good money. Just for wearing white, somebody is calculating how much extra soap, how much blue, how much tinapal, how much stars we have to spend. It's for my dress, then for my wife's dress. Lord, is it the ministry that you called us? We cried. We had cried. My dear brother, my dear sister, it's not an easy path. It's not an easy path. But the Lord had never forsaken us. The Lord had never forsaken us. My dear brother, my dear sister, our God is great. Faithful is He that calls you. Number 4. To know His mercy endures forever all situations. Psalm 118, the passage that we read. Please permit me just to read all the 17 verses quickly. From verse 1 down. Oh, give thanks unto the Lord for He is good, because His mercy endureth forever. In all difficult situations. It's a part of my testimony on this day. It is His mercy. We are what we are today, but by His mercy. There are times we are broken. There are times that we wept alone, we wept together. We didn't want our children to see that difficult path. We didn't want our children to know those tears. My dear brother, my dear sister, His mercy endured forever. Let Israel now say, let Robert Simon now say, earlier one of our brothers, some years back, named a Facebook account. At that time I was not taking that in. Yesterday, a day before yesterday, I was talking to Vinod, I just gave that name. Because I know our media is right to have that name. You might have seen, or you will be seeing, when we will play that truth nugget, it will come RSIM or RZIM. One of our brothers gave this name long back for his Facebook account, Robert Simon International Ministries. Now I don't mind. I get information from people from Canada, people from Saudi, people from Malaysia, people from France, different places. This live streaming is reaching. We are getting messages. That's why here he says, let Israel now say, they were slaves, they were in the wilderness. God's mercies endured them. We crossed waters, we crossed fire. God's mercy endured them. Let Israel now say that His mercy endureth forever. His mercy endureth forever. Let the house of Aaron now say that His mercy endureth forever. House of Aaron were slaves. They were in wilderness. Now they are the high priest. Let the house of Aaron now say that His mercy endureth forever. Let them now say that fear the Lord. Now say that His mercy endureth forever. I called upon the Lord in distress. I called upon the Lord in distress. The Lord answered me and set me in a large place. The Lord is on my side. I will not fear. What can man do unto me? The Lord taketh my part with them that help me. Therefore shall I see my desire upon them that hate me. Not only upon them that hate me, I could see my desire. The Lord is working out in my life. What is a wonderful occasion to bear these testimonies with you. I was suffering from an acute back pain. I was driving on two wheelers. A small bump will send the pain all through my vertebra, to my neck, to my head. I would not be able to bear my pain. I was taken to the doctors. Doctor strictly said, I should not travel on two-wheeler. I should not sit on the chair that I was using then. He said I should sit only on a cushioned chair. Two days later, I was traveling with one brother, Pakyanathan, to a very remote village near Red Hill. Very remote village. I was a pillion rider on his bike. He just let in a bump. Ba! The pain went through my nerves. Tears started rolling down. Tears started rolling down. Lord, I could not bear the pain. That evening, never I could dream. The Lord grants our desire. An unknown, but till this day I don't know him. Only once I met him, twice. After that, no contact with him. Yes, a crewman, a Hindu, who listened to our cassette in the ship, who listened to these messages in the ship, he gave $2, $200. At that day it was 10,000 rupees. The very same day, it was the advance we paid to buy the first ambassador car. My dear brother, my dear sister, he grants my desire. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in man. It is better to trust in the Lord than to put confidence in princes. I trusted many people. If I have trusted many of them, they all have forsaken them. I could not have continued that ministry. It is vain to trust in all those people. All nations compass me about, but in the name of the Lord will I destroy them. They compass me about, yea, they compass me about, but in the name of the Lord I will destroy them. They compass me about like bees. They are quenched as the fire of thorns. For in the name of the Lord I will destroy them. So many difficult situations will encompass you about like bees, honey bees. Thenikalai pola vandu abbe sutti kollum. Back, you can't do anything. Like theni, they will encompass you about. Many difficult situations may come. But like thorns, they are like thorns. But they will be quenched very soon, as the fire would quench thorns. Verse 13. Thou hast thrust sore at there, at that I might fall. But the Lord helped me. The Lord helped me. When a man said, who left the church, with about 35 families, he predicted, with his anointing he prophesied, oh, the cream of the church is left. Past is doomed. Avladha. The cream of the church is left. The Lord has not forsaken. Thou hast thrust sore at me that I might fall. But the Lord helped me. The Lord is my strength and song, and has become my salvation. The voice of rejoicing and salvation is in the tabernacles of the righteous. In the house of the righteous there will not be weeping and screaming. There will be songs and shouts of praises. The right hand of the Lord doth valiantly. The right hand of the Lord is exalted. The right hand of the Lord doth valiantly. I shall not die, but live and declare the works of the Lord. My dear brother, my dear sister, I'm allowed to tell you. How do we know the hand of the Lord is with us? We go through difficult situations. People will turn against you. Everything seems to be dark. You think that it is impossible to move forward. But in all situations, the hand of the Lord. How do we know the hand of the Lord is with you? He will uphold you. He will lead you through. He will make you prosper. Every point is telescopic, complementing one another. Every point is complementing one another. He will make a way for you. He will show to the world that you are not forsaken. He will make things, your endeavors prosper. And His mercy will endure forever and ever. In all situations, Last night I thought, certainly I don't have time to explain all these verses and these passages. Just I want points to you. Number 5, to establish His glory in His servants. To establish His glory in His servants. We read in Malachi chapter 3 verse 17 and 18. And they shall be mine, saith the Lord of hosts, in that day when I make up my jewels, and I will spare them as a man spareth his own sons that serveth him. Then shall he return and discern between the righteous and the wicked, between him that serveth God and him that serveth not. We saw immediately, serving the Lord is not just standing and preaching. Serving the Lord is in different forms. You can serve in the Sunday school. You can serve in the VBS. You can serve in the worship team. You can serve with the law office team. You can serve in getting this place ready for the Lord. Serving the Lord is different ways. The most dangerous way of serving the Lord is becoming exhibits, standing and preaching, being in the choir. Probably everybody may not see the web streaming team or production team, but those who are recording, the video recording, everybody will see. The worship team, the singers, the musicians, everybody will see. This is the most dangerous, vulnerable. All eyes will be upon these people. Many a time, people then serving the Lord, they seek for pulpits, they seek for stages, they seek for some ministry. They think that's only serving the Lord. My dear brother, my dear sister, the Bible teaches us very carefully, all they that serve the Lord will not go to heaven. One day the Lord will tell them, workers of iniquity, depart from me. They say, Lord, in your name we prophesied. Lord, in your name we caused the dead to rise. In your name we performed miracle. Or we taught in the Sunday school. We were in the choir. We were in the media team. Lord, we were serving you. The Lord would say, depart from me, ye workers of iniquity. What is literally serving the Lord? The highest form of serving the Lord is waiting in the presence of God. There are three different services in the tabernacle. Those who are serving in the court, they serve in the light of the sun, cutting the animal, skinning off, burning it, etc., etc., bringing firewood for that, serving in the court. There are some people serving in the tabernacle, trimming the wicks, keeping the bread, putting the coal, burning coal for the incense. They will not be carrying firewood. They will not be cutting animals. But they are serving the Lord in the holy place. There are some people serving Lord in the most holy place. What will they be doing in the most holy place? What will they be doing in the most holy place? Being in the presence of God. They will be under the Shekinah glory. As an individual, we may not cut an animal, we may not skin that animal, we may be able to bring the firewood. We'll be doing all these things under the sunlight. We may be having a ministry, bringing the shewbread, bringing the word of God, bringing the revelation, trimming the wicks, putting the incense, conducting prayers, spreading the savor of the Lord. That's also we have to do. And the greatest ministry, serving the Lord in His presence, in His light. My dear brother, my dear sister, Paul says one place, you will not be crowned if you don't run the race according to the rules. No one can win a game if you cannot follow the strict rules and regulations of the game. Your ministry in the Sunday school, your ministry in the church, a love feasting, everything would go waste unless it is approved of the God. You have to serve the Lord. When you serve the Lord, surely the Lord will make a difference between those who serve Him and those who don't serve Him. Those who serve the Lord and those who don't serve in any form, you have to serve the Lord. And in Isaiah 66 verse 14, Isaiah 66 verse 14, and when you see this, your heart shall rejoice and your bones shall flourish like a herb, and the hand of the Lord shall be known toward His servants. The hand of the Lord shall be known toward His servants, and His indignation toward His enemies. To understand this, you have to read from Isaiah chapter 65, rather from verse 1. You have to go through 66:14. We don't have time to read all those verses. 65 verse 13 I read. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, behold, My servant shall eat, but ye shall be hungry. Behold, My servant shall drink, but ye shall be thirsty. Behold, My servant shall rejoice, but ye shall be ashamed. 2 days back, two servants of God came to see me. One servant of God said, many years back, I think it was in 92, that I preached in his marriage. I don't remember. He said, I preached in his marriage. And he said, based on this verse, I brought God's message at his wedding. What is that? My servant shall eat. But those who don't serve the Lord, they'll be hungry. My servant shall be satisfied. And others, they will be thirsty. My servant shall rejoice. Others will be ashamed. Behold, My servant shall sing for joy of heart, but you shall cry for sorrow of heart, and shall howl for vexation of spirit. And you shall leave your name for a curse unto My chosen. For the Lord God shall slay thee and call His servants by another name. You may call the servant of God by any other name, but he will be known by the name in which God calls him. My dear brother, my dear sister, I love to show you a very powerful passage. What the Lord God does to His servants. A very powerful passage. I don't know how many of you have noticed that. If you got a copy of the Bible, kindly turn with me to 1 Kings chapter 18. We shall read verses 45 and 46. And it came to pass, in the meanwhile, that the heaven was black with clouds and wind, and there was a great rain, and Ahab rode and went to Jezreel. You are living in this world. There was no rain. There was no cloud. There was no dew. For 3 years, there was great famine in the land. No rain. The heaven was shut against the country. There was no rain, there was no rain. Elijah challenged the Baal priests after whom Ahab and his wife were going on. They cried all through the day. There was no answer for rain. There was no answer for rain. Elijah built the altar. Ahab saw. The prophet of Baal saw. The people of Israel saw. The king's men saw. Elijah built the altar, made the sacrifice, looked into heaven and said, Lord, hear me. Ennai ketarulum. Lord, hear me. Fire came down from heaven. God answered through fire. On Mount Carmel, Elijah was praying. 7 times. The heaven was still bright. No cloud. No sign of rain. At last, kaiyalavu megha. Cloud to the size of the palm. Elijah said, King, rain is going to come. Run. And everybody was getting ready to flee. Within a very short span, heaven became dark. Heavy downpour. Ahab, who knew there was no rain for 3 years, who knew the prophets of Baal could not bring an answer from God, he knew that Elijah's prayer was answered. Fire from heaven came. Sacrifice was accepted. Ahab saw that. Mighty prophet of God. Elijah prayed. Rain came. Ahab could remember 3 years back Elijah said, without my word there will be no rain. After 3 years, the same Elijah before the same Ahab prayed. Rain came. Elijah said, King, escape, run. I was broken. You may wonder why I was broken. Ahab immediately got his chariot ready. He was trying to run. After seeing this great miracle, this king who has sold his soul to his wife Jezebel, he didn't even have a courtesy to Elijah. He knew Elijah was a great prophet. There was that minister, the Ethiopian minister. He told Philip, okay, join me. Okay, join me in the chariot. This king Ahab didn't want to show that courtesy to this great man of God, to this prophet, to this mighty man of God. Even after seeing this miracle, the riches of your eyes, the power, the position of the king could blind, could harden the eyes of an Israelite king. He could have told, that's what I thought, he could have told Elijah, now I know your God is God, now I know you are a man of God. Elijah, join me at the chariot, we'll go. My dear brother, my dear sister, that king paid no courtesy to the man of God. His pride, his position, his power didn't allow this man with a camel's clothed with a camel's hair, this rustic man of Carmel, the king didn't want him to sit by his side. My dear brother, my dear sister, God is mighty. Why do I say this? Verse 46. And the hand of the Lord was on Elijah, and he girded up his loins and ran before Ahab to the entrance of Jezreel. And you are the servant of the Lord. God would prove that the strength of you, the strength of God that is upon you, will be more than strength of the horses of Ahab. Shall we clap our hands and worship the Lord? Clap your hands and worship the Lord. It is not necessary chariots of Ahab. I don't know how the heart of Elijah was, but yesterday it was a great solace to me when you can't get the chariot of Ahab. You can't sit with the chariot with Ahab on his chariot. When Ahab cannot be courteous to ask you, join me. Hallelujah. Chariot from heaven will send to you Elijah. Not on Ahab's chariot. Not on Ahab's chariots. The Lord will take you to heaven on a fiery chariot. My dear brother, my dear sister. One day a businessman said, oh, only the business people can support any ministry. Every ministry is depending on only business people. The time that I got, we started this ministry, I prayed unto the Lord. His ministry is running not on the chariots of Ahab. It is on the chariots of fire from heaven. My dear brother, my dear sister, for the glory of the Lord, I tell you, if you read the book of Ezekiel again and again and again, the hand of the Lord was upon that prophet. The hand of the Lord was upon the prophet. I remind you, Acts chapter 11 verse 21. The hand of the Lord was with the apostles. The word increased. Many gave into the knowledge of salvation. Just pray that the hand of the Lord should be upon you. The hand of the Lord upon the wicked is for their own condemnation. It is not just the hand of the Lord is upon you, but it's a question. Hand of the Lord upon you for your blessing or from your damnation. If your life is pleasing to the Lord, the hand of the Lord shall be upon you. The hand of the Lord shall make way for you. The hand of the Lord will grant you your endeavors. If the hand of the Lord is upon you, it will prove you will not be forsaken. If the hand of the Lord is upon you, everyone will see in all different situations his mercies endure forever and ever. If the hand of the Lord is upon you, it will establish your service to the Lord. It's a question. The hand of the Lord is upon you. In the name of Jesus, I prophesy to you, the hand of the Lord be upon you for your blessing, to carry you through, to open up the way when there is no way, to prove that the Lord is with you, his mercy endures forever, to establish everything you do for the name of the Lord, for his kingdom's sake. The Lord is with you. He will not leave you. He will not forsake you. The hand of the Lord was with the apostles. The hand of the Lord is with you. The hand of the Lord is with me. The hand of the Lord is with us. Shall we pray?